Lois from Be Gritty Horsemanship, and I thought today I'd share with you a little bit of our morning routine feeding. This is Rue, and this is, it's about time we feed, so he's fussy. But even being fussy, he has to back up, mind his manners. Come on, Rue. We feed our guys an extruded feed and alfalfa cubes soaked. Alfalfa is fantastic for them. It's great for weight maintenance. It's great for putting weight on. It's great for allergies, coat, you name it. Alfalfa fed in moderation or fed correctly is a great thing. So we are big fans of that. I'll feed everybody else. I just have a stack of buckets here. So you can hear everybody's waiting, fussing. There's Myra and Jill and Nikki. Perry's down there. Cletus is pacing and Virgie's there. So I'm going to feed everybody and then we'll head on up to feed the horses up in the top field. So me and the dogs are headed up to feed the horses in the top field. There's three up there that stay out 24/7. Max, Mouse, and Sunny. And I'm going to show you a little bit of how we feed them. This is probably a common problem for a lot of people. Sunny is a bit pushy and tends to steal Mouse's food. So we just do a little training while we feed and we move his feet, kind of claim our space, let him know that he doesn't rule the field when we're in there, and everybody has to stay at their bucket and eat politely. So let me get up this hill and then we will feed. We have had, my goodness, last month, I believe the count was a bit over 80 inches of rain for the last year, and normal for Virginia is about 36, so we are swimming in mud, and it has not stopped. I believe the next few weeks we have rain, snow, ice, and mud coming, so it's staying wet. I'm not complaining, because I like the rain, I like grass, but it has been a struggle sometimes. So let me get these dogs and we'll go feed. So here's our three outside guys and their field. So we feed them on the fence line down here. Mouse eats right here by the gate. And then everybody else will go down the fence line. And that's Max, this is Sunny, and that's Mouse in the back. And you can just see Sunny and Max are a hair bit pushier. She's waiting politely there. Waiting sort of politely. So let's go on in and see what we got. Okay, so I'm through the gate. Here's my food, Mouse's food pan. She's waiting here patiently, but Sunny and Max are over here, not where they should be. So I use a stick for times like this. Gives me an extension of my arm, and I'm just gonna move these boys out of the way. I'd like them to go to their, the way they're headed, all the way to my right, but they're waiting. So I'm gonna apply a little bit of pressure. I'm gonna ignore Mouse. I'm just focusing on the horses I want to move, and she's worried about me, but I'm not gonna worry about her. She needs to get over that and realize I'm focusing on these two. So there goes Sunny to his pans. See, Max is kind of halfway. So I'm gonna feed Mouse and make sure they stay where they are. Good girl, Mama. And then I'll feed the boys. And I expect them to hang out and wait on me and let Mouse eat. So there you go. There's Mouse's food. She's being polite, and here they come again. So, I'm gonna get their buckets. Sorry, I'm doing this with all this with one hand. And I'm gonna get my stick. I'll move them again. I expect them to go over to their feed buckets and wait on me. And you can see they know the routine. They're just impatient, which is fine. Now, I'm gonna make sure they head a little bit farther down the fence line. They're kind of heading out. And that means they can roll back and get Mouse's food if they want, which see, they're kind of headed back. So I'm gonna wait them out, apply some pressure, and see, here they go. So they're gonna run down in that swamp by the water. But I'm not gonna and they knock the bucket off the well cap. I'm gonna keep applying that pressure. Get boys. They have to go up and wait at their food pans. Rooster. There we go. You guys had to get a little in the action there. Now Max is waiting. Sunny's still trying to vie for food. Rooster, I have to fuss at my dog. Okay, so I'll let them settle and then I'm gonna go feed them. Becker, get out. And they're not ready. Becker, get out. So I'm just gonna, all I'm doing is protecting Mouse. If it takes them a little longer to eat, well, it takes them a little longer to eat. But I'm not gonna let them swing back here and take her food. Again, when I walk in this field, it's about me. It's my field, not theirs. They don't get to push her or me. Rooster. Rooster, go lay down. Good boys. So, I'm gonna let him chill for a sec and I'm gonna feed him. I'm gonna put my phone down and I'll be right back. So I fed him and they're right here. Everybody's eating quietly, waiting. Max is right there, Sonny's right there. They tend to finish about the same time. I don't worry about them stealing each other's food. They're pretty equal. But I do expect them to stand there and wait. Again, the more I can move their feet and fix this pushiness at feeding time, the more well-behaved they are for everything else, for leading, for groundwork, for riding, everything. We try to take every opportunity we can here to establish that we can move their feet. And again, if it takes a little extra time at feeding time, it's well worth it in the end. Keeps everybody safe. Keeps other horses safe. It's just a good practice to follow. So to follow up, I've got these two boys right here eating quietly. I had to move their feet, create some space, move them away from Mouse. But again, now everybody's quiet. They're eating here, super quiet. And then Mouse, all the way on the other side of the field, right here by the gate, is eating. And she's able to finish her food in peace. She's not fretting. She's not worried about them coming after her. Again, moving feet and controlling feeding time just gives you a little more foothold as the leader. Every chance you get, we like to prove that we are the leader. Being the leader helps the more passive horse like this be comfortable, and it also helps all the way on the other side of the field. The more dominant horses realize that they're not top of the pecking order when I walk in the field. And again, it just helps establish that point. When it comes to groundwork and things like that, these guys will be so much better. Sonny had a habit before we came here. He was here when we moved, and he had a habit of kind of pushing people over and pushing through the gate and just being super rude. We're gonna work on him this spring, but right now we're just reinforcing that we can move his feet. This will help our groundwork in the spring immensely. So again, just our little tip for the day. Everything you can do to move your horse's feet and prove to them that you control the space around you will help you go much farther in your groundwork and in your riding. All right, I need to be off to clean some stalls, so everybody have a good day, and we'll talk to you soon.